just about set to kick off. And now it's time for the coin toss. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Rice will be kicking off, and you can just feel the energy in the air for this opening kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line. Nebraska's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football.
Throws it into coverage, and it's intercepted. To the 10. Touchdown, Owls.
Great job here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house. Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
He makes the PAT. And ready for the kickoff. Fielded at the 4. And he's taken down at the 26. So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
You know, after that last turnover by this offense, the momentum has really turned in this game. And right now, you got to believe this defense is going to come out and play with a lot of intensity and a lot of aggression. The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays. But if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He's under some heat. He heaves it deep. Doesn't get there. And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. Got the corner. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Rice is up a score. Has some daylight. Tackled after a decent pickup. He kept it himself and picked up about 6 yards. And down he goes at about the 47-yard line. For a nice run.
Really smart call here by the offense going with the counter. It fooled the defense just enough to give the tailback room to get through.
And he's tackled around the 36-yard line. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receivers.
Pitches it. And he's tackled after positive yardage. That's good for 9 yards. That makes it 7-6. Hey, Mike's 15. missed him. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Fires it out. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line.
Well, on third down, we expected them to go to the air, and they did just that, picking up the first down.
Tackle made around the 14-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. Rice up 7 points. Scrambling around. Tackle at the 8. That makes it first and goal. He's on the run. They get about 4 on that keeper. Touchdown, Rice! And he hits the PAT. It was an 11-play, 61-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. The score now, 14-0. They line up to kick this one away. The Owls had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. He'll take it from the 2. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 26-yard line. Rice's defense is playing lights out right now and pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. The way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
He wants it all going long. And he's got it. What a tackle. That was going to be a touchdown. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 29. After a decent run up the gut.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Man left, man left. Four down. Hey, check Mike 57.
Inside the 10. Touchdown, Nebraska.
He kept it himself and created the whole thing with his feet. Boy, was that fun to watch or what?
And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Rice is making a bid for an upset here today, Herbie, but do they really have it in them, do you think?
Brad, it's a great start by this team, but I just can't see them holding up for 4 quarters. I think eventually you'll see the better team emerge.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Rice is up 7. Passes to the back, incomplete. It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. That's a loss of about 5.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
play across the middle. They'll bring him down
at about the 35.
So the defense does their job well on that series.
The defense is going to head to the sideline with a real sense of accomplishment, knowing that they've just shut this offense down.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. Tackle at the 35. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. He's taken down at the 44-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Throws it in a hurry. Brought down right around midfield. He's at the 40. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
From the 36-yard line, first down. We played one. Bryce leads it 14-7. We're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Now he tries to buy some time. And they make the stop
around the 34-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From the 34-yard line, it's second down. Just throws this one away.
Sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 25. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Airing it out long. Incomplete.
There was just no way anybody could catch up with that pass.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 25. Quick throw. And down he goes around the 30-yard line. He scrambled, and he's going to be sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
And they're coming after this punter. Oh, excellent punt. Gets to about the 41-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And he's hit before he could go anywhere. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you, and that's what happened.
They bring him down.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
And that'll be three and out. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Complete. It's the junior. There's a strike complete. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 45. He makes his way out to about the 35.
How the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
From the 37-yard line, second down. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. And he's level at the 29-yard line. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Quick throw to the tight end. He gets hit out of bounds around the 22-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Scrambling. They bring the quarterback down.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you're definitely going to feel it the next day.
looking to dig themselves out of a little hole here after the sack. It's second and 14. Throws complete, big loss. Tenth play of the drive. To that quickly. He's at the 20, and he is drilled at the 17.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
They'll line it up for the field goal. Rice is looking to go up by three. He gets it up, and he got it. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Cornhuskers quarterback, Kirk, he has done his job. Unfortunately, there's 22 guys on a team, and one guy's doing a great job. The other 21 aren't so much.
That's not going the way they had hoped or planned. Right now, you're right, the quarterback's doing what he needs to do to be able to move the ball. But the running backs, the wide receivers, the offensive line, the entire group, they've got to do a better job right now. Look at that scoreboard. They've got to be really frustrated to think that they're down. Now, they still have time to get back in the game, and we'll see if they can adjust their mental mindset.
Quarterback stats are one thing. Winning the game is what's more important.
Great first half of action, and we're hoping for more of the same. 17-14, Owls.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here? Got a good, well, a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. Yeah. We're loaded, man.
That's right. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Is it stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Rice has a three-point lead. Runs outside for a nice game. He's going to try and scramble. Now he's going to run and watch out. The ball pops free. The defense has it. He really wanted that ball, didn't he, Kirk?
Well, you can't teach hustle like that. The linebacker was determined to get the ball there, and he did.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
He's at the 40. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That'll make it 7 inches.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. He's taken down at the 42.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Tackled after decent pickup. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That'll make it second and 4.
Nice gain as he works the right side.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
So it's 3rd down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Tackle around the 32-yard line.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
Nebraska can tie it up here with this kick. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he just drills it from long range. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
Good game here, 17-17. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the 3rd quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. And he tackles him hard at the 22.
I'm not even sure the ball carrier saw the corner coming for him. That happened so fast, he never had a chance to make a move.
From their own 22-yard line, it's 2nd down. Scrambling around. Tackle made right around the 26-yard line. He wants it all going long. This one will fall incomplete. Gets out to about the 48-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Gets it. He's in space. He's at the 40, and they push him out at the 37.
Wide receiver's role in a play-action pass is to get into position and to hit his spot in timing and rhythm with the quarterback. And that's exactly what they were able to do on this last play. You realize you've got a little bit more time because of the play-action, and it gives you more time to get to that point that the quarterback's looking for you to be at, but make sure you do a good job of selling your route and getting in position to give an open target for the quarterback.
From the 37-yard line, 1st down. Play fake, looking to run. Decides to slide. He picks up a good 7 yards there in the quarterback keeper.
That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
Tie that. Go down. Hey, check Mike with the 7.
takes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
A yard, if that, on the quarterback keeper.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Up the middle for a nice gain.
Breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line. And a quick throw. They'll bring him down around the 12-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Nebraska's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he just gets rid of it. It's second and 10. Ball on the 25. Throws it out right to the running back. And he's tackled at the 29. He's on the run. And they make the stop, the 37-yard line. To about the 37-yard line. And that's it for quarter number three. Folks, we got a great game on our hands. The Cornhuskers with a touchdown lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. The senior. He's taken down right around midfield. He's tackled around the 42-yard line. He's out of bounds around the 41-yard line. And down he goes, right around the 36-yard line. It off, brought down at about the 35. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
This is the 11th play of the current drive. Inside the 10. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal. He scrambled. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he hits the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Tackled for a loss.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on their own 24. Go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. Knocked out of bounds around the 37-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. Slides down to the ground. It's second and six. Ball on the 41-yard line. Just under three to go in regulation. Feeds it to the back. Nice run there as they work the outside. Is out to the tailback on the screen. That's a great tackle at the 50-yard line.
Number 57 on the tackle at the 50-yard line. That makes it second and eight.
It's second and eight. Ball on the 50-yard line. Might have been some early movement up front.
Offense. Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still second down.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he's taken down at the 45-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Give to the tailback. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
That brings up fourth down. That's a huge stop at this point in the game. With under 2 minutes left, it's not going to be a lot of time to move the ball. So you got to get aggressive quickly.
He fields the punt at the 13. Looking for the corner, and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. Late in the fourth quarter, tie football game, an important game for both these teams, and this is where you find out who your leaders are. Just over a minute left.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. Across the middle. And this one's going to get intercepted. Tackle right around the 50.
It was time for somebody to step up and make a play. And boy, did the defense come through. Now they've got a chance to take the lead. That was huge.
From midfield, first down. He's scrambling. Tackle made at the 50. Now he's scrambling. He gets sacked on the play. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. Fourth and long here after the sack. Oh, man, did he take a hit. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? Going to try and scramble. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Diving for extra yardage. The Owls are going to call their second timeout. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 38. This looks like their last shot to get it to the end zone. Once and all, going deep. We're going to overtime. That'll do it for regulation, and we are going to settle this one in overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. Finds his man. First down. And that sets them up with a first and goal. He's had a good game, snaring passes for 100 yards.
I think the quarterback and this receiver right now are clearly in the zone. The defense needs to do a better job of adjusting their defense to be able to slow him down. He now has over 100 yards receiving in this game.
From the 1 yard line, it's second down. Tacks on the extra point. It's first and 10. Ball on the 25. touchdown. So they come up with the equalizer.
This offense did just what they had to do. They knew they needed 6 points, and they got it. That was just a great series.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. We've got a dandy here, folks. We're heading to overtime number two. From the 25-yard line. It's first down. Touchdown. Big play. So the offense steps up and gets a big 6 points here in double overtime.
And that gives them some breathing room for the time being, but I'll tell you, the way this game is being played, I wouldn't be surprised if we saw this offense on the field again in a third overtime.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. First and 10, ball on the 25-yard line. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Got his tight end touchdown. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. The extra point. And if you haven't had enough yet, we're going to a third overtime. Extra points are no longer allowed, and if anyone scores a touchdown, they'll have to go for two. He lets it go. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. So with a first possession in the third overtime, this offense takes it in for six.
There's no resting easy yet. They still have to stay on the field and try to convert a very crucial two-point conversion.
They'll go for two in this situation. Rice with a six-point lead. Scrambling around. He's got the two. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. He's looking for six. It's caught. Touchdown, Nebraska.
Doesn't seem like anything is enough to put this game away, does it? I can't wait to see what happens on this two-point conversion.
So the offense is going to go for two. He's in for the conversion.
They'll live to fight another day with that conversion. Or at least another overtime period. But they don't have time to celebrate.
Why stop now? We're headed to another overtime period. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. They'll bring him down around the 6-yard line.
First and goal.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
The way the safety was playing up toward the line of scrimmage shows you what they think of the offense's passing game. Not a lot of respect for it.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 8-yard line. Here's the halfback on the screen.
Touchdown, Nebraska!
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the 2-point conversion. Nebraska up 6. He's on the run. They got it.
These two teams have been trading punches all day. Now you wonder if that score and conversion will be the knockout.
From the 25-yard line, first down. Got a man tackled for a loss. That's a loss of 4 yards.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Here's a running play. He gets out to about the 21-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. He's tackled at the 9. Touchdown, Owls. Well, they're going to try for the 2-point conversion. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's got it for 2. This one might never end. We're headed to another overtime. First and 10. Ball on the 25. And down he goes. Right around the 30. They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
He zips it out to the left.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From the 30-yard line, it's third down. And he hits him hard at the 40-yard line.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 25-yard line.
Has some daylight.
Nice play to set up first and goal.
Stop
right around the 8-yard line.
I think a corner loves to have a chance to come up and make a play in the run game. So often they get labeled as just great athletes and they just want to be involved in the passing game and being able to defend a receiver. Here you see an attitude from this corner as he comes up, reads the play, and makes the play in the backfield.
And he's tackled at about the 3-yard line. So here we go. It's third and goal from the 2-yard line. Touchdown, Cornhuskers. Nebraska's staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.